Welcome to another Nucida video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified data management experts will reply in time. Business, technical, and IT departments often need to work together to process, analyze, or test important and complex data structures. But it's often too cumbersome and takes too long. SQACE is the low-code platform for IT and business that helps you to reduce complexity, achieve your goals faster, and fully realize your potential. Today, I will introduce this new data management tool. With this tool, business experts can directly implement analysis, data checks, data transformations, and much more themselves, all without a complex tool zoo, easily understandable together on one platform. IT and business experts can better fulfill even complex data missions, for example, data migrations or tests of data processing, or web services in a modern and agile working method, and faster than ever before. SQACE offers self-explanatory no-code components. With them, anyone can explore, check, and even perform very complex data queries themselves without SQL knowledge. Many standard tasks such as data comparison can be solved with SQACE components, and with just a few clicks, results are automatically saved and can be easily further used and shared with others. Even extensive workflows can be created via drag and drop, for example for automated data checking and data cleaning. Our SQACE videos have triggered many positive reactions. Many customers and interested parties have been waiting a long time for a tool of this kind, which enables even database laymen without SQL knowledge to solve extensive and complex database management tasks easily and in a very short time. Even the best database experts with profound SQL knowledge cannot even begin to keep up with the speed at which SQACE creates SQL definitions. Let's analyze again the data we used in our first videos. There's an address ID which doesn't help us much at the moment, because I really want to access the street, house number, city and so on. That's why there's the join proposal, which I can click on. SQACE directly suggests which tables in the database I can now cleverly join. To do this, the tool analyzes the database and searches for corresponding foreign key constraints. The results and information are then displayed here. So once referenced, data such as payment and rental can be selected here next to address. I click on the desired element and see that all the information is displayed here graphically and correctly pre-assigned. First, an inner join is created. If I don't want an inner join, I can select a different type of join here. For example, a left join, full join or cross join, which is shown by a corresponding symbol in the overview. The join condition is defined here and can be customized. Several join elements, i.e., several columns, can also be considered here. Below this are the output columns, with the rows marked in green, representing the left-hand side, and those marked in purple, representing the right-hand side. Perhaps I don't want to output all the columns. I'm not interested in the second address ID, for example, and I don't need address 2 or the last update, which I can simply deactivate using the checkbox. I can now execute the changed query again. Ah yes, now we have a readable address, i.e., a street as well as a district and a city ID, whereby the latter again only is a key and does not contain any information that I can read. However, I can now easily create another join. I can also do this again here. There is the city data to join. But we've already done that. That's why I'm now showing you another option. If the desired table is not displayed in this join proposal, I can simply drag and drop the table I need into my workplace from the data explorer on the right. I then have access to the desired data. But I can also drag and drop it directly onto this element. SQACE then asks how I would like to combine the data, e.g. horizontally, meaning join, or vertically, meaning union. I would like to join for now. Again, thanks to the join via city ID, the corresponding output columns are added. Now I can deactivate unnecessary columns again. For the country ID, I now add the next join to obtain the country-specific data. So, Now I'm going all the way up here. Or rather, if I run this now, I don't see any significant changes, because we haven't adjusted the output columns at the top here. The readable city and country columns are still missing, which I can activate in the output columns. After executing the query again, the city and country information is now also displayed in plain text in the two columns on the right. And the whole thing is a representation of a SQL statement, which I can also view here. This now consists of several subqueries and joins. No database administrator would have coded this SQL query in such a short time. So even real SQL experts, who can program quickly in SQL, have no chance in a performance comparison. But we'll go one better. I want to use a file from another database, or from a file via the mission file hub, e.g., use a file to join my query with said file. Here I have file called customer-exported.csv. After selecting this file, my CSV reader opens automatically, which reads my data from the file and presets or defines it according to best guess. For example, the tool has recognized the file encoding as UFT8. However, I can also select any other encoding. We already have everything pre-selected by the best guess heuristic. For this CSV file, the semicolon is the separator, whereby the first line to be read in is recognized and pre-assigned as the header line. I can also ignore rows if I want to, but you can usually just click through because everything is automatically set correctly. Here I can also specify the data type of the expected columns, and finally I can specify what else should be included in the output. I have now included the customer exported file reader in the customer query, and can now join the table directly to the customer table above. Here we can still see the old result, where we had 599 rows. However, I should not implement the inner join via the address ID, but via the customer ID. This can be easily corrected. With the inner join, only rows existing in both inputs left and right are output at the end. This means that only 200 rows are output instead of 599, as there are only 200 rows in the customer exported file. This also makes it very easy to integrate files into queries using a join, and you can see where each table came from. The question of how the individual data was incorporated into the entire query can be answered quickly. Here too, I can look at my data profile directly, with the column statistics, most frequent values and so on for all the results I have in my grids here. The value distribution is also interesting. It can show us whether the data is, for example, normally distributed or evenly distributed. And the bottom section is for free diagrams, such as line charts, column charts, or other chart types that we want to configure freely. SQACE offers professional SQL and multi-environment support and is easy to integrate with other systems, for example with test management systems or CI/CD pipelines. This case makes the reuse of components simple and promotes collaborative work across team boundaries. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our SQACE certified data management experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about data management and software quality. Happy data management and testing. See you next time.